Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision. Excited for this one. This is a kickboxer of the highest order. He has so many different kicks and punches in his arsenal and figures to try to keep this on the feet here tonight.
The beautiful thing that he does is throws that front push kick to create distance when a guy starts to get close and wants to wrestle with him. He throws it, and the moment you're back at his range, he starts to blast high kick. He doesn't always intend on landing it, but he beats up your arm with high kick after high kick after high kick. As you get desperate, you start to run into knees, and he does not need much space to land a knockout punch. This guy is one of the best strikers we've ever seen in the UFC.
And if you don't find the striking range early against this guy, you could be in real trouble. Ah, yes, the sweet science. This guy could have been a professional boxer, probably a world champion if he so chose. He loves the MMA game, but his boxing is certainly his bread and butter.
I mean, a guy that was on par to make an Olympic team. And that is in one specific skill set. When you reach that level, when you're winning the national championship and you're about to go to the Olympics, but you choose a different avenue,
yeah.
You decide you want to fight mixed martial arts, it's truly something special. He has the most educated jab I have ever seen in the octagon. He throws the jab, it always comes back to the face. It never goes to the hip. And if you rush him, he has the ability to switch stances from conventional to southpaw and land a great counter right hand that will put your lights out.
Better jab than your guy, Rosendo Sanchez?
Oh, it's unbelievable. He put Rosendo Sanchez to shame.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! Five rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 6'6" tall, weighing in at 206 pounds. The Sniper! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a boxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Dynamite!
You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
Ready.
Got here in 2016, we've been showing up strong ever since.
Because every time you go to MSG, you should come with a big event. This is a phenomenal arena. This is a fantastic fight environment. New York City, baby, the city of dreams.
And he landed the right hand there. Oh, man, this ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Strong bottom work here, staying busy.
Oh,
All right, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh, yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage off.
All right, closed guard now. You got to be careful, though. He's got a lot of submissions off his back. Well, you got to be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Recovery, man. Right back to his feet. Just missed with that right hand.
Nice kick.
Oh, really using his reach advantage as he landed the jab there. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
Look at him working and trying to shut the liver down. Right hand punch in the clinch.
Just out of the range with that right hand.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Well, he continues to stay busy. What do they say, DC? Punches in bunches?
Punches in bunches. He's landing them upside his opponent's head over and over again.
Clean left punch followed by the right.
That right hand hurt him a little bit.
Oh, left hook to the head. It's blocked. Right hook to the body. Takedown defense holds up. Staying busy in the clinch to avoid a separation. Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect.
I mean, he's cutting him down to size with these beautiful leg kicks.
He blocks the punch. Flips the punch nicely there.
Big powerful punch land. Now he gets back to range. Ooh, what a head kick.
Swifts on the elbow. Well, DC, headgear's not allowed, but he has raised the hands, and he's doing a nice job protecting the dome.
He's doing a great job of blocking his head. A lot of times, those shots to the head will knock you out. Not this time. This guy's making sure nothing lands. Nice straight punch.
All right, Muay Thai clinch. A lot of elbows and knees could be coming from here. We'll see how he chooses to attack.
Yeah, it's a very dangerous position, but an advantageous one for the offensive fighter. Watch for the defensive guy to try to break this immediately.
Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home. Punch coming, it's blocked. All right, so he lands a jab there. Pretty nicely done, DC.
You can really control a fight just knowing how to fight behind your jab.
Oh, he hurt him bad with a jab.
Final seconds here.
Straight punch lands. Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's gonna break him?
Stop.
Excellent job last round. Really like your ground control. This round, we want to do the exact same thing. Let's start this off with a big...
All right, well, the crowd enjoyed those 5 minutes. DC, take us through some of the highlights from that previous round.
Face punching at its best. Ha. He loaded it up. He threw it straight, threw it long, and over, that punch found the target. It allowed him to really dictate the pace of that round.
All right, DC, second round is getting underway. Round one, not the round of the year necessarily, but some good in there.
And it's not always gonna be. We have two very talented fighters. Sometimes it's very even. That's what we saw in round number one. Nice punch there.
Nice job by the fighter here to continue to block the shots coming his way. You think he's trying to sort of fatigue his opponent here a little bit?
He's kind of watching and seeing everything that's happening in front of him. Later, you'll see him start to throw counters after blocking shots.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that land, DC.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
And both guys really throwing with authority. just misses with the straight right. Attacking the body now, that shot blocked. Just missed with the left there.
Great punch.
Great punch.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body. He just continues to punish his opponent's midsection here in this round. Man, DC, his hands look good. A lot of volume, a lot of accuracy tonight.
He's doing a great job being accurate, but he's also very fast. Look at the hand speed.
Right. Slips the punch. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue.
That's a big strike right there.
And now he goes with the combination of punches to the head, potentially some concussive damage there.
I mean, absolutely concussive damage. Landing all those strikes to the head, he's very accurate, he's very fast, and he has a real confidence every time he throws his punches.
Just over 3 minutes now to go.
He loaded up on that right hand, too.
Beautiful combination there. Good series of punches by him there. He has been busy throughout.
He's doing a great job with the hands. He looks like a professional boxer out there.
Well, he's really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive now here and starting to find himself in the pocket.
Beautiful punch.
Oh, that's a nice straight punch there.
Threw the punch, got to the target.
Oh, nice slip there. It sounds simple, right? Just hit and don't get hit. But this guy's defense has been sharp tonight.
Cat and mouse. You got to play cat and mouse. Hit, don't get hit. He does a great job of that.
Oh, is he a good counter striker? Counters beautifully with the left hand.
It's a good right hand right there. Oh, nice. Big punch land. Boom.
Looking for that left hand, not there. Oh, landing a punch with the left hand now, so certainly putting it all together on the feet tonight.
Doing a lot of work with his offhand.
Oh, spinning back fist out of nowhere.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Just misses there with the left. All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
Nice punch lands over the top.
Obvious redness on the right side of his body. Well, we talked about that reach advantage as you see him land the straight punch there. Great job using his length in that situation. Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively protecting the head and sort of maybe letting his opponent gas out a little bit with all the volume.
His opponent sees the target, but he can't get to the target. So he'll continue to throw, and he'll continue to wear on his own gas tank.
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense?
That one snuck in. Nice.
Able to land a combination there. All right, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target pretty quick.
I mean, just right away, blasting the jab after jab after jab. He's a phenomenal boxer with a vast understanding of fighting behind an educated jab.
Straight right is there.
Ooh, big shot land.
And a nice job at least staying upright on that.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick.
Good series of strikes for him there, staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable.
Nice straight right lands. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. Let's take a look back at some of the replays, DC, and if you like the kicking game, that was the round for you.
Yeah, man, he used his kicks beautifully. He managed distance, managed space, and eventually those kicks started to really take an effect on his opponent and slow him down. He has to stay the course next round.
All right, so back-to-back entertaining rounds. We'll see how it goes in this round. We'll see which corners sort of maximize those 60 seconds on the screen.
This is what happens. Very skilled, very talented match fighters coming together. Nobody has really taken a lead in this fight. Let's see who does it going into the next round.
Oh, flush knee to the body. He's got the length advantage in this fight and certainly made it count in that exchange. Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take. All right, good job by him there to raise the guard and protect his head.
He's doing a good job of keeping the guard high, blocking his head, making sure he's not taking those damaging strikes up top. Punch over the top.
Oh, collar tie. Both fighters exchange in the pocket here. And they separate.
He's grabbing the back of the head. Pulling forward on the head and then landing a beautiful punch. Really got his opponent on notice here.
Straight right hand, no good. Oh, significant strike attempt there, but a huge block.
Nice strike.
Already closes the distance, gets the single collar tie.
Head kick lands.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws his jab. He may float a right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down on the right hand. He really doesn't seem to have the intent on landing it. He's got to be confident that it's going to land, and he's got to really throw his whole entire body into those strikes. Ooh, what a punch.
Right hook to the head, blocked. Both fighters throwing heat now.
Nice job of hiding that head kick. Oh, yeah, right hand.
Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked.
Beautiful strike.
Oh, he's really starting to apply pressure on his opponent here. Different approach here in the last couple rounds, and it's the exact sense of urgency that you want to see from a fighter. Take the judges out of it. Single collar tie now.
Ooh, head kick lands. He's hurt.
Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop him. John, stop him.
Lands flush with that right hand. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position. Timely defense there. Huge block for him.
Nice looping punch.
All right, so he continues to land that jab. His opponent said he was ready for it, but doesn't appear.
You're not ready until you're in there. You can watch all the film you want. You can spar as much as you want, but until you feel a guy with a fast jab like this, you don't understand the precision of that punch.
Well, defense doesn't necessarily win championships in MMA, but he's doing a nice job blocking these shots.
He's not allowing his opponent to get any damage off on him by blocking all these attacks.
Oh, back to the overhand right, swing and a miss.
Nice. Good stick.
Try to establish that jab. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Flush right hand is true. Would you look at the size of that bruise on his body? His opponent will likely continue to attack. Timing his shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very accurate. Big head kick lands.
Oh, nice land with the knee. You see the taller fighter having no issue getting the limb to the target there. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Lands with the ground and pound here.
Nice working there. Excellent ground control. Your
All right, let us look back at some of the action from that previous round. DC punches in bunches.
I mean, over and over, he landed that big punch. And every time he landed it, he got the reaction that he was looking for. His opponent really did start to take notice every time he was loading that strike up.
All right, next round is underway. You know these are two of the more conditioned fighters on the roster, so cardio is not going to be an issue here. And for some fighters, you know, you can have one of those adrenaline dumps or the cardio abandons you on fight night. Not the case for these two guys. Both look very fresh as we start this next round. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Oh, and he lands another knee there, DC. It doesn't always pay to be the taller fighter. In this instance, it most certainly did.
Nice punch, man, over the top.
Keeps going back to that jab, keeps throwing that jab, but unable to land. Spinning back fist is there. Some fighters don't check a lot of leg kicks. That one was checked. Oh, nice knee to the body for him there. Very nice. Punches and bunches for the longer fighter. He landed another strike there. All right, single collar tie now. Connects with a right hand. Pretty good punch that week.
Nice right punch by this young man.
Well, at this point, he's got to be way up on the judges' scorecards, clearly winning the fight, and largely has gotten it done with his striking.
He got it done with his striking. He fought well behind the jab, but it was the significant strikes that really did make an impact on the judges' mind. Nice punch land.
Big left hook coming, it's blocked.
Left hand punch to the clinch.
Lunges forward with a left there. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Ooh!
Oh man, head kick lands.
Had a nice jab there, champ.
The jab was a lost art in mixed martial arts. Guys have found it, and they are fighting behind it real well.
The 1-2 punch is true. 3 minutes remain in the round.
Big punch land in the middle.
Nice connection on the counter punch there, and oftentimes, DC, it can be easier to be a counter striker when you have such a pronounced edge in reach. Oh, he lands the Superman punch. Certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches in bunches. He's doing a great job. What a punch.
Well, he misses with the left punch there. Punch is blocked. Well, you didn't see a lot of the body work from him in the earlier rounds, but he's certainly getting after it here. Big shot to the body connects there. We'll see if he can follow it up. And they separate. Oh, single collar tie here. Misses with that punch. Here he is back in the clinch. Counters with the left hook. Nicely done there.
Good punch, Lance.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. 90 seconds remain in the round. Oh, a little single collar tie there. Straight right hand now, just misses.
Watch knees to the body.
Back and forth we go. Well, if you're going to leave your body that wide open, you're going to pay the price that he certainly did there as his opponent lands flush to the midsection.
Nice. Oh, big head kick.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be, and if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
Oh, spinning back fist. He didn't telegraph that one at all.
Big kick lands.
Oh, high level stuff as he counters with that right hand. Beautiful. And follows up with another one. Both fighters hanging down in the pocket and both landing. Final seconds of round four.
Great punch landed with so much power.
Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
Here we go with our next round, DC. Pretty good game plan in the previous round. Attack the body to great effect, and we'll look to continue to do so here.
He has done a great job of making the investment. The investment to the body that may not pay dividends early, but as the fight goes long, you will see it start to pay itself off.
Oh, that's a nice strike. All right, so a good job defensively by him here as he raises the guard and prevents any damage.
Shades of James Toney. Always seeing things coming at him. He's such a great defensive fighter. Very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Misses with the right hand. Nice jab, follows it up with a nice right hand. Strong defense there to block the shot. Nice head movement to slip the left hand.
Oh, big punch land.
Got the single collar tie. And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Body kick is blocked. Oh, I love the jab. I know you love the jab. That was a nice one.
It's my favorite punch in all the fights.
Just a slip there. Scuffs the takedown, no problem. And they separate. Takedown defense holds up.
Left hand punch from the clinch. Good punch.
Trying to land the elbow there to no avail. Oh, tags him again with a flush left hand. Big shots being landed on both sides here. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Now he counters with a right hook to the head. All right, well, it's late in the fight. Time is of the essence, and when you're clearly losing and you know you need a finish, risk management goes out the window.
Oh, yeah. No more risk management. Either get knocked out or you knock him out. One way or the other, you're gonna lose. You can lose by decision or you can lose by knockout. But at least when you go for the knockout, you give yourself a chance to try to find your shot.
Oh, and he connects there. Pretty nice punch there.
Great job finding the range to land those punches.
Whiffs on the right hand. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Oh, and he is getting tagged repeatedly. Nice combination of strikes up top.
Oh, beautiful combination up top. I don't understand why the guy is not moving his head. Get your head moving, son.
Man, the body work really starting to take its toll here. Obvious redness on that right side.
Ooh, what a punch.
Well, that's not what you're looking for defensively. He moved right into that hook, and his opponent wisely lands it to the body there. He has been increasingly more susceptible to that strike. Let's see if that one gets his attention. Oh, huge overhand there.
Oh, man, he lands another punch to the head. Nice head kick.
Straight right, he misses. Back fist. Nice right punch followed by a left. Ooh, blocks the shot. Just misses with the left hook.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
1 minute to go in the fight. Just missed with the straight left hand.
And then he throws an overhand right.
And now they are throwing both sides with conviction. Spinning back fist. Blocks the shot to the body. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if he can follow it up.
He's landed that punch over and over again. What's he gonna do to follow up?
Oh, tags him with the left.
That left hand has been really effective tonight.
Just misses with a left hook there. Rips the body there. Went for the inside leg kick. Nice placement there on the left hook counter.
What a tricky head kick.
All right, so the fight goes the distance as we await the judges' scorecards, but certainly a dominant striking effort out of that fighter tonight.
John, he used his best weapons in order to carry him to a decision, a very clear decision, in my opinion. A great performance tonight by this young fighter.
The official decision is in. It resides with the venerable Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score the contest 50-45. Playing the winner by unanimous decision, Dynamite!
All right, so the judges are in agreement tonight. He is your winner by unanimous decision. Certainly pretty easy fight to score, I thought.
Yeah, I thought it was an easy fight to score. Whereas his opponent had a few moments, he was the one that truly did lead all the interactions. He's the person that truly did dictate if the fight was standing or on the ground. This is his fight. He won this fight, and he won it in dominant fashion.